na lang. So in different sectors, okay, watch sa pangalan tayo si Jen, make sure buka. Make sure buka, so we will avoid injuries. Okay, and then you fit checklist for handstand, and cartwheel, but I'm going to provide the standard checklist which you can use if you are. Okay, maybe if you want to change it, you are, you can add up the different idea, and you are. Whatever yang rasanya to complete the checklist. Okay, I have some questions today. What if teachers can't do it? Banyak ni. What if teachers can't do it? Saya ni seorang cikgu pendidikan jasmani tapi tak ada background gymnastics. So I can't do cartwheel, I can't do handstand. Yeah, workout okay lah, balance okay lah.
Yeah, make a lot of
And it is in the syllabus and you have to do it you are. So what you can do is, using the checklist tadi atau by using the checklist, you instruct the students.
Saya makan ada.
All the descriptors yang dekat sana. You instruct the students atau macam, okay, I want you to do begin forward roll by standing straight up. Dia yang imagine while listening atau imagine dia buat satu persatu. Okay, so now pakai minimum ya boys. So bila kita dimakai, yang all the descriptors ada explain and instruct the students satu untuk buat the movements in all the handstand, cartwheel atau hand forward roll. Instruct dulu. Whether durang boleh imagine or not, and do it balik-balik until it's perfected. Kalau masih jod na mau, ya kami mau ada example-nya. Pasal students, kalau durang after they see, baca durang dapat buat. They can't imagine themselves. Durang ada yang percaya to students, law of imaginations.
Sorry. What you do is, you hold like this.
Okay, this is an awkward. I have to explain like this. Okay, so what you do, what you can do is you can instruct them dulu, okay? Instruct dulu whether they can do it on their own or with their imagination. Kalau tidak, you have to learn yourself. You have to learn to know before you conduct the class. At least you can do it, although not perfectly, you can still do it. Aku mesti. Okay, please learn. Ada yang macam, oh, I can't do this, I can't do this. You have to learn. Okay, cikgu-cikgu. And the second question is, what if student satu pulang tak dapat buat? Balik-balik pun 8 tahun lagi kita ngajar gymnastik ini. Fodol saja, 8 tahun ke fodol saja. Dia pun ngalik sudah pusing. Indah cuma lurus. Okay? Then, the points yang bisa kita bagi di sini ini tadi. The points yang bagi arah ada rubrik. Kan ada checklist sana. Terus kita apply arah rubrik sana. Kan ada rubrik tadi. Maybe, because they have 3 sections di sini. Proficiency, ada this is including this kita dapat ganda. Ada proficiency ini is the skills, the techniques tu. So bila ia dapat skor di sini, bis kita assess durang in terms of behavior and cooperativeness in class. Atau sudah point extra point durang. Okay? Semua tu kita assess. Semua all the skills in gymnastics. Pasal di sini syllabus you have to do all lah. That's why today saya tekankan Arabis kita. When you can't do it, you have to learn. Okay? Yes.
Okay.
Okay, so when we have these students, yang oversized students, I'm sure semua pernah ada di kelas kan, in the class. So, apa yang tadi saya cuba tekankan atau bila kita ni apply to this, maybe ia dapat grade for skills also 0 or 1, maybe 2. Okay? You can, you can support him or her, okay? Support untuk behaviornya sama progressive-nya in class. For example lah, macam I can't do it at all. Okay, dia buat balance maybe dapat sikit sejak point. Handstand dia dapat buat langsung. Okay, maybe dia boleh tolong in the class. Okay, handstand ada supporter. Never mind, teacher, I can't do it this. I can't do handstand, but I want to support him. I want to support her. You can give marks sudah sana. That is the marks sudah. Okay. Kalau ia dah realize, on macam mana dapatkan markah dalam kelas, macam ia don't want to do anything, jangan dibiarkan. Okay, stop. Okay, Charlie, you come here. You oversize kan? Oversize. Charlie, you come here. Okay, I know you're getting hard points on the skills. What you can do is to get more points, to get more marks, you be more competitive in class. Become their support, okay? Cuba do this. Bagi tahu ya, tell them. At least they have extra marks di sana, okay? Kita boleh buat tu semata. Okay, that's pretty much all of it. So we've got all balance, control, handstand, and cartwheel. So any problems for this morning session? Anything? Any question again? Kita ada problem. Everything semua tahu sudah macam mana buat lah. Yes, it's in the syllabus. Yes, akan. Ya tentu. Pasal tadi yang saya katakan pasal dalam checklist, kita ni mesti support dulu. Okay, kita ni sudah buat all the checklist atau. So cuba satu, Ali kami bagi 2 points, Ali bagi 1 point. Kan saya sudah explain tadi kan? Macam mana Ali 0 point, Ali 1 point, 2 point. Okay, bila yang balik-balik kita dapat, mesti bersupport juga. Dan atau subjectivity kita ni yang membagi markah. So macam, kalau kau dapat buat ni, saya bagi kau 2 point ni. Kau buat sendiri saja. Okay, tapi bila nak dapat ke, aku cuba disupport, support. Dapat, kau buat yang support, tapi saya terpaksa bagi 1 point saja. Kau boleh buat tapi di sini support. Dari awal sampai habis kita dah assess. Okay? So, any problems again? Any questions? Dadah.
Assalamualaikum teachers. Now, what's going to happen this afternoon is I need all of you to be on time because we're starting straight away at 1:45. We're finishing about 11:40, in about 6 minutes time, and I need all of you to be at least here by 1:30. We have a long afternoon, so be prepared with yourselves, a big hat probably. Do I have teachers here or my participants? You're all so quiet. Are you all selesa, comfortable? Okay. You can put your bags down now. Di bawah. Maybe keluarkan some stuff untuk menuliskan. Alright, everyone's ready?
Yes.
Good? Now, one more games. You did that with Amal. So, with Dayaku Amal just now. It's one of the ways you can have a warm-up with your student instead of the usual just stretch, right, do this, follow this. You can have a little game like yesterday we had a trees and squirrels. Those are little games that you can use to warm your students up at the beginning of the lesson, right? Because as you can see, some of your heartbeat masih laju, right? Ada yang relax saja, chill. Ada yang kiap, panasan maybe. Ada yang feel a bit panicky. Especially after yesterday, trees and squirrels. Who screamed while playing? I'm sure some of the guys did as well. Right? Okay? So those are the games that you can make your students move, know one another, and also as well as have fun. Right? Now, what we're going to do in this session? We're going to do assessment in TGFU. Can anybody tell me what TGFU is?
Teaching games for understanding.
Well done. Teaching games for understanding. And the session that we're going to look at is striking and fielding. This part of TGFU. We're going to have a quick recap so that you remember what it is. What TGFU is. What is TGFU? It's a whole different approach than what you're used to. Okay? It's more student-centered learning rather than teacher-centered. And then it's created by these two famous guys, Bunker and Thorpe. Right? Now it's already been used and implemented into curriculums such as countries as Singapore, UK, the United States as well, Australia, Hong Kong, and from what I've heard, there's Malaysia as well. What is TGFU? It changes the way games are learned. Shifts from the technique base. We are used to teaching, belajar dulu skill in it, teach how to kick, teach how to catch, then you play the game. Whereas in TGFU is, you play the game first, then you teach the skill. Because in TGFU, we are looking more at the tactics, the cognitive yang kita sini, rather than the skill. Right? The skill will be about 40% in TGFU. We're more on the cognitive bit. And then teachers now are the facilitators. Whereas in the technique approach, teachers are the coaches. Am I correct? That's what you look at, macam you kick, alright, that's correct. That's wrong. Whereas in this concept, teachers are facilitators. You will assist the students, support them. And then now students are more active learners. And more. Active learners, they now can tell you what type of tactic to use. When they watch a game, they can tell you what happens next. Sometimes, yes. Right? Especially with the current, previous World Cup. Right? Some of you, I bet myself, can tell whether that team will win a trade up. Sometimes. Because you know the way they play the game are solid. Terbaik, dia punya key players ada dalam sana. But they work as a team and they are smart players. That's what we are looking for in our students. Smart players. The TGFU model. It's a step-by-step procedure. Okay? You design a game first. Design of the game. You get a full game. Let's say football. And then you modify it so that you teach one particular concept. In football, can I ask you what you are looking for when you're teaching in TGFU? Let's see if I want to see a recap.
Space.
First we'll decide. Football, what type of category does it belong to? Is it invasion?
Invasion.
Alright. Give me a tactical concept or a tactical focus you use in invasion.
Creating space and maintaining
creating position. Space. Right, in football. We take a game, football,